Hey there, everyone. This is just a quick announcement that I have been working on adding property-based testing capabilities to SerenityOS. It's now currently in review by the SerenityOS maintainers and should hopefully land relatively soon. And I'd like to show you what it's capable of. So if I open this test generator file, it gives you this new randomized test case macro and a bunch of helpful generators in this new test randomized namespace. If I open generator.h, right, test randomized gen, and there's, you know, integers, vectors, that sort of stuff. And you can use them like this, right? So for example, this will give you the numbers 0 to 10, there's this vector, this will give you length 1 to 4 of unsigned integers, and so on. And when the test that uses one of those random values, when it fails, the library will find the smallest example that still fails, right? It will shrink it down and it will present that to you, which is nice because then there's not so much noise. The signal to noise ratio is much better. And so having all of these, I'd like to start a small video series where I try using these on the many, many libraries and utilities and programs that SerenityOS has. And in doing so, I'd like to introduce you to certain types of property-based tests and show them off on some real-world useful examples. So let me give you a little teaser. This is the gzip library, libcompress-gzip, right? And it has, you know, it has some public API, but in particular, I am interested in decompress-all and compress-all, which is somewhere here. And if I open the test gzip test suite, you can see it has some, you know, unit tests with like specific bytes that should decode to specific strings and so on. And these are great. These are very good, you know, these tests that it does what it wants to do, right? But what if we have just been lucky? What if there is some kind of bug? Let's say when you have two characters repeating or some special magic value, right? So like, how can I be sure that I didn't just like miss those cases? Because I have just used a little, you know, hard-coded example. And so that's the appeal of the randomized testing. We can test the API with a very common property-based test, the round-trip test, and I am already showing it here. So I am creating a vector of, you know, between 0 and 2k bytes, and I'm compressing it, I'm decompressing it, and then I'm checking that, you know, the value hasn't changed, right? We didn't lose any data. So this is the round-trip test. And this is already very strong, I would say. If this was the only test we had, maybe, you know, the implementation could cheat it with just like doing nothing in the compress and decompress operations and just giving me the value back. But, you know, we do have these unit tests next to it. So it does have to do some sort of useful stuff, at least for, you know, these unit tests. And so if it does useful stuff for specific strings and I am just, you know, running the randomized test with arbitrary strings, I think that gives me very strong guarantee, or maybe not guarantee, but, you know, evidence that the right thing is happening. And so this is just a single example of what we could do with property-based testing. And I want to give specific examples for, you know, more of these types of tests. I want to kind of teach you how to do property-based testing on these real-world examples. So, you know, we could have Oracle tests where you have some sort of, you know, known correct implementation, let's say of a sort function, and you are creating a new one, you know, faster one, this sort of like dim sort 2.0, and the sort functions should really behave the same on any input, right? And so you just, you know, generate random data, run the two functions on it and check the results. Are those the same? They should be. Or we have model-based testing where, you know, you have this sort of complicated system and you make a little model of it, right? So instead of some sort of, you know, multi-threaded key value store, you know, that like saves the files and does all sort of stuff, you can just have like in-memory dictionary of items and you can kind of model your complex system with that. And then you randomly generate a list of operations. And, you know, again, you run those operations on both the system under test, the complex thing, and your simple model. And again, the results should agree. And what's really awesome is the shrinking part, right? So it will find like 100 steps during which somewhere something goes wrong, and it will, you know, find what to throw away, what numbers to like minimize, and it will give you, let's say, like seven steps to reproduce the problem. And it usually is pretty like obvious what's happening there, because if you remove any one of those failing values, you know, failing steps, it would start working, right? So usually, again, the signal to noise ratio is awesome. And there are many, many other ways you can use these randomized tests to check your system. It's truly a powerful tool. I can't wait to use it on, you know, all the SerenityOS libraries and, you know, utilities and stuff. So if this sounds interesting to you, I'd love you to join me on this tour of property-based testing. I hope you learned something, and we are going to make SerenityOS better in the process. So stay tuned.